Where does this joy come from? What gives it wings? And makes it magical? What makes a child's dreams come true? The answer is simple. It's one's love for their sport. These words could describe the life of Nastia Liukin. Her origins in the sport are deeply rooted. Her father, Valeri, represented the Soviet Union at the 1988 Seoul Games, winning 2 gold and 2 silver medals. Her mother, Anna, was a world champion in rhythmic gymnastics in 1987, but never competed at the Olympics due to injuries. After Nastia was born, they decided to leave Russia in 1992 and move to the United States. It was here that they created a gymnastics school from a converted grocery store. They couldn't afford a babysitter, so Anna and Valeri would bring 2.5-year-old Nastia with them to the gym.
She was showing Valeri something that she learned from older girls. And Valeri kind of stopped and looked, and he asked her, How did you know this? I mean, who told you? She's like, I just saw the girls doing this. And so I think that was our first realization that she potentially has a gift. And to be very honest with you, we had a very mixed feelings because with the injuries and the long hours of training and the sacrifices that you have to go through. So our first reaction, both mutually, were like, oh, absolutely no way.
When they saw how much passion and love I had for it, and I just wanted to do it, and I never wanted to leave the gym or take my leotard off, then, well, if she really likes it that much and if she wants to do it, then we'll let her do it, but we're not going to push her into it.
Her parents gave in to Nastia's wishes and let her train at the gym with Anna coaching her. As she progressed, they switched her to another coach.
One day she came in the gym with a big bruise under her eye. Just scared me. I go, what happened? What is going on? She goes, well, I did Sukahara. I was like, what did you do? You just barely can do handspins. That did it. That was the last day somebody touched Nastia. Nobody touched her anymore, except myself.
With her father as her coach, she won 2 national all-around titles and was a member of the 2007 World Championship U.S. team. Now in 2008, they set their sights on the Beijing Olympics. ...10 a.m., August 17th, the National Indoor Stadium. The competition for the individual all-around in women's gymnastics. 24 gymnasts have qualified. They will be divided into 4 groups of 6. The top qualifiers will be in the first group. 2 are from China. Yunyan Zhang and Yilin Yang. Both won a gold medal in the team event 2 days earlier. Representing the United States, 16-year-old Sean Johnson, the current U.S. and world champion in the all-around, and 18-year-old Nastia Liukin. Johnson and Liukin finished 1st and 2nd, respectively, in the qualifying round. What many thought would become a rivalry has turned into a friendship. When the U.S. team arrived at the Olympic Village, the two insisted on being roommates.
We were probably the 2 most similar girls on the team. We both liked to go to bed early and get our rest was important for us. So we really got along really well. And we made a little countdown, a calendar, and we wrote in every day what competition it would be. And so finally we were about to mark it off, and it was like all around finals. And we both just like looked at each other and we were like, I can't believe it's here.
The all around consists of 4 disciplines. The vault, uneven bars, balance beam, and floor exercise. Like every major competition she's been in, Nastia will be coached by her father, Valeri.
Normally, I am so nervous for competitions, and this is probably the most confident that I've ever been in my entire life. So he comes up to me and he's like, is everything okay? And I'm like, yeah, I'm like, great. And like, yeah, I'm fine. He's just like, okay.
And I see she's very confident and very comfortable right there. It just freaks me out. We don't say this. We never say this. She never did this.
One person not at the arena, Nastia's mother, Anna.
I just get really sick sitting there and watching. It's not about winning, and it's not about medal. It never been for me as a mother. It's just really my stomach would turn when I see my kid, you know, doing all kind of hard tricks. And all what I wanted her to do is to land safe and be happy with what she did. And then that will make me happy.
The first event, the vault. Yang of China leads off. She receives a 15.175 from the judges. Now it is Nastia Liukin's turn.
Vault's not always my best and strongest event, but going into the vault, I felt confident. My training was going really well. And, you know, the one thing that my dad told me was when he came up to me and he was just like, you know what? He was like, no matter what happens, I just want you to enjoy this and have the time of your life.
I think when I talk to her, I'm trying to comfort myself. It's sometimes I think, you know, she knows what to do.
She receives a 15.025.
It was just such an amazing start to what I knew was gonna be a great day, and see that huge smile on my dad's face from the very beginning just gave me even more confidence and strength.
Even though Sean Johnson doesn't stick her landing, her vault has a higher degree of difficulty and she receives the highest score so far. Union Zhang's fall has all but eliminated her from gold medal possibilities. When the first apparatus is completed, Sean Johnson leads the first group. Nastia is fourth. Next, the uneven bars. This is Nastia's strongest event. Valeri has designed a routine with the highest degree of difficulty in the hopes that Nastia will outscore the rest of the competitors. She will be the first to compete.
Moving on to the bars was nerve-breaking for me. I was nervous very much because I knew if she's not gonna hit, there's no competition anymore. We're done. There's one giant extra she does before the dismount to speed up. All these crazy difficult routine, D's and E's. So if you messed up one skill, everything goes apart. You just stay over there and pray, you know? Things should work.
I did have a step on the landing, but I knew that I had pretty much done as best as I could.
The plan works to near perfection, and Nastia scores a 16.650. Johnson performs well, but her lower degree of difficulty is reflected in her score. She drops to fifth place. Yang is the final competitor of the rotation. She is awarded the highest score of the day and moves into first place, leading Nastia by less than a quarter of a point. Sean, currently in fifth, is the first on the beam. With the highest degree of difficulty in her group, this is her chance to move up on the leaders. Johnson scores high with a 16.050.
I was last on beam, and so I decided to take a seat on the floor and kind of get in my zone. And a few people before it was my turn, my dad was like, well, you want to get up and start moving around, you know? And I was just like, okay.
Next is the current leader, Yilin Yang of China. If she scores well, it will be difficult for Nastia to overtake her.
I was worried about Chinese. After bars, she was still ahead. And you know how good Chinese on the beam, right? Chinese are excellent on the beam. And that's what scares me. Well, obviously, I don't talk to her about it. I don't want to create a